Bon dia, bos dias, egunon, good morning. Rock here from Life Sciences. And well, yes, I'll talk about the elephant in the room. So if you were to think about two words on this 2020, I think most of us would say coronavirus and vaccination, right? So I'd like to talk about if they are the good and the bad, if they are the yang and the yin of the year. But before I do that, I'd like you to take a moment to shut up the noise and think through what this 2020 has brought to us. I think this is the most changing year in our lives and for our lives to come. Please do not think about numbers, think about people. Are we there? So, to begin with, I'd like to talk about vaccination. Why to vaccinate? Is there scientific doubt on vaccination? And for me, this can be resolved with two questions. One, what is a vaccine? And the second one, are they effective? So moving on the first one, vaccines are therapeutic preparations that come with a pathogen representation. And this pathogen representation can be of different sorts, of different ways. So there's not a single type of vaccines, and that is a message that is important. But in the end, all these vaccines, what they are doing is they are triggering a specific immune response to the patient. They are preventing this individual from getting infected in the future. And then the second and obligatory question is, are they effective? I don't believe any negationist will be between us, but I think most of us in the street, in our families, may find people that do not trust vaccines. So what I want to show you now is an argument for that, an argument for saying a piece of shut the fuck up data, you know? So what I'm showing you here is a list of diseases for which we have developed a vaccine, for which vaccination has changed the death rates, which you see in the second column. You see there the numbers of deaths these diseases were causing at their peak year, and you see the cases that we had in 2014. So in the final column, you see the percentage of decrease, right? So you see how vaccination works. There is no doubt that vaccination is there, and it's the most successful public health policy that can be applied. So, but even if then showing something like this, you don't get to convince people, you can show them what poliomyelitis did to people. It's a very destructive disease. You have here a picture. You can show them and they'll probably shut up. So moving on, everything seems darker now, but this 2020, we are working on a solution. But is a single and an only one solution? Is only one vaccine what we are doing? No, the answer is not. There are many, many, many vaccines being developed, many big biopharmaceutical companies behind them, many countries behind them. So there is no point in doubting about this, because just imagine that in 1, 2, 3 years, these vaccines, this collective effort, get to the decrease we saw in the previous table. Imagine them. That for me, it would be like the most important collective effort in human health done ever, right? So please do not doubt about vaccines. And moving back to the yin and the yang, actually my project is not on vaccination itself, but is on an actual therapy for COVID-19 patients, so for people who is already infected. Because vaccines work as a prophylactic system, but we need treatments for COVID-19 patients. So what we take advantage of is the role of these neutralizing antibodies. These antibodies, they are the natural immune response to viruses and to coronaviruses, and basically what they do is they prevent the viral spread throughout the body. They prevent the viral entry at the mucosa, at your neck, but they also prevent the viral spread from infected cells to neighborhood cells. And how do they work? Basically, they prevent the so famous viral protein spike from interacting with a human receptor, the AC2. They bind there in the middle and they prevent the viral entry to the cells. So, BSC, we are computational, right? So how do we work on a therapy like this? So what we did is studying the viral proteome, the proteomes of SARS-CoV-2, and we we got to predict the parts of these proteins that are recognized by these anti-COVID-19 antibodies. These parts are called epitopes. And then what we do with these epitopes is we send them to the clinic, the hospital clinic, where our collaborators synthesize them, and then they expose these epitopes, these candidates, to the blood of patients that have overcome COVID-19. Then what we see in this plot here, you see in red the positive ones, and in blue a pre-pandemia set of controls. And what we can see is that our epitopes are indeed working. There, in the blood of these patients, there are antibodies that are recognizing these candidates. And then our purpose in the end will be to identify these antibodies and then synthesize them massively to try them, to set a clinical trial and see if they are effective in actual patients. With this, I'm mostly done, but I wouldn't like to finish without going back to the yin and the yang. So I think it is true that coronavirus and vaccination have been the good and the bad of this year, but in a year that things get blurred, that things get uncertain, what I think is clear that everything that is really, really important becomes clearer. And for me, that is that science needs to be put back at the center. Science needs to be the basis for policies and data-driven decisions. And who else than us, scientists, that whose data is our craft, to help politicians in their difficult task. So I'm almost done. I wouldn't like to finish this talk without extending my solidarity to the victims of the fire last week in Badalona, because SARS-CoV-2 is a very dangerous virus, but I think inequality is a most dangerous virus that we are facing and that we need to face in the years to come. Thank you all.